Hello everyone, I am Tomalika Chakraborty, Assistant Professor of Guru Nanak Institute of Pharmaceutical Science and Technology. Today in this video, I will be discussing importance of plagiarism in academic writing as a part of enrolled students of academic writing course of SWAM NPTEL. The next question is, what is plagiarism and why it is important? Why are so concerned about plagiarism in research? You know, the researcher and academician are renowned because of their papers, because of the work, because of the books they publish. So all of a sudden, if it happens that this researcher is actually caught in the offense of plagiarism, in stealing somebody else's work, so that will hamper his or her reputation. It will be a black mark in his career. So one should take precaution and stop. Basically, plagiarism. So for that, you need to know the true terms of plagiarism. The term like copying and borrowing usually is referred with plagiarism, is associated with plagiarism, but a plagiarism is a much more serious offense than copying and borrowing. So Merriam-Webster Online Dictionary has said, to plagiarize means to steal and pass off as your own work, to use somebody else's idea without giving any credit, to commit literary theft, and to take somebody else's idea, modify it as your own idea, and reproduce it. So that is basically plagiarism. And all this should be strictly avoided in research and in academic writing. The next question is very funny, that words and ideas can be stolen. Words and ideas are not objects. So how it will be stolen? Yes, it is true. It can be stolen because according to US law and laws of many other countries, if you are producing some novel idea, then that is a part of your intellectual property right and it will be protected by your copyright laws. So at no instance one can copy it from you. And if you are copying it from the others, you are stealing it basically. You are plagiarizing. Now, as many of you are reading this or listening to this particular slide, this particular video, you should know that how will you detect a plagiarism? How will you understand that yes, you are plagiarizing? So for that, I have put some instance in points which are actually plagiarism, like converting someone else's work as one's own, copying a sentence and you just change the sentence, change some word, that is also plagiarism. Failure to put quotation marks when it is required, that is plagiarism. You are writing something from somebody else's paper but not giving a citation, that is plagiarism. And even you are giving wrong information about the source of quotation, that is also plagiarism. I give you a small example. Like you get to see this picture. I have taken it from some source. But I have cited that particular source. If I would have not cited the source, then that would also have been a plagiarism. Next, we will move on to the classification of plagiarism. So the first and foremost important type of plagiarism is direct plagiarism. As you get to see the symbol, that is cut and paste, you are cutting and pasting word to word without acknowledgement. I give you an example. I have taken this sentence from turnitin.com. Attention, changing the word of an original source is not sufficient to prevent plagiarism, and I have modified it. One has to remember that changing the word of original source is not sufficient to prevent plagiarism. In the bold, you get to see that the whole patch of sentence have been just cut and pasted, just copied word to word. So that is basically a part of your direct plagiarism, and every researcher should first give the priority to prevent direct plagiarism. Next is your self-plagiarism. As the word suggests, self, one's own. You have taken your own work, own data from one paper and you have put it into another paper, but you have not informed your professors, the co-authors who have helped you. So that is a criminal offense and that leads to plagiarism. So you can take your work from a previous paper and put it into the other paper, but you have to cite that previous paper. So that is basically a part of self-plagiarism and need to be avoided. Next is mosaic plagiarism. Mosaic means in patch. So here also the plagiarism occurs in patch. Like you have taken one phrase exactly, inserted a phrase without quotation. Or you have paraphrased a sentence having the same structured sentence, same form and in the same place, right? Even if you give footnotes, then also it is offense and it is punishable. Like I have given you an example to make you understand that in this is a particular sentence obtained from turnitin.com. Most cases of plagiarism can be avoided, however, by citing sources. I have written that one can avoid plagiarism by citing sources, but this citing sources is the phrase which I have taken directly from turnitin.com, but I have not put it into the quotation mark. Or in the next thing you will see that the acknowledging that some of the material has been borrowed and highlighted and information to chalk out the source, this is the same structured sentence as that which is given by turnitin.com. I have just paraphrased it, but it is the same structured sentence. So this is also a part of your mosaic plagiarism, and this needs to be avoided. Next is accidental plagiarism, a plagiarism by accident. You know why accident occurs? Because you are unaware, because you are ignorant. So you don't know what is plagiarism. So you unintentionally paraphrase a sentence. You mistakenly forget to quote the sentence. Or you forget to cite a source, because a researcher has to keep in mind while writing a research paper all these points. So if you don't know that what is plagiarism, you are unaware of this fact, then you will do these mistakes. So that is a part of your accidental plagiarism. So first be aware. Don't be ignorant about plagiarism. First you be aware of the plagiarism, and then you write your research paper. Then you write your journals. Then you write your books. So that is the why. That is why the video is so significant. This is also very important that you need to know the consequences of plagiarism. Consequence of plagiarism, like if a student does a plagiarism, it will lead to student's reputation destruction. Why? Because the teacher will not believe the student, because the student has copied from somebody else's work. Like if you are a teacher, you see that two students have copied the same picture, the same writing, what will be your impression to that particular student? The student can do nothing of its own. So that will destroy student's reputation. As a professional, as a matured person, if you are doing plagiarism, again your reputation is being gone in your institution, in your organization. Why? Because they will believe you cannot create your own novel work. You copy from the others. You do that punishable offense. So they will, even you are terminated from the job if it happens like that. So that is basically your destruction of professional reputation, destruction of academic reputation. And here we can say both academic means for the students as well as academicians. Academicians, they are renowned for their publication, for their research work. And if all of a sudden it was found that they have just copied, they have just borrowed ideas, nobody will actually give that respect to that particular academician, right? So their reputation will fall. Next is your legal repercussion. Legal repercussion, that means you may be legally accused. That means you may go to the court. You may be infringed because of this particular aspect. Because this aspect of plagiarism is highly unethical. Highly unethical, right? So you can be accused and you can go to the court. Next is your monetary repercussion. Monetary repercussion, you have to give money. You have to give money because you have copied. Like a lot of years before, when Samsung has got a mobile phone in the market, and that was very similar, and the softwares were copied from Apple iPhone. The Apple company accused that particular Samsung, and Samsung had to give a lot of money and also have to ban that mobile in the market. So this type of happening can occur and can lead to a black mark in the reputation of the company, reputation of the researcher, reputation of the academician. So these things has to be avoided. So last but not the least, I will suggest every listener, every audience of mine to be novel. to bring out novel work, to bring out novel idea rather than copying others. So after all this slides, I think you have got a true aspect of your plagiarism and the classification of plagiarism. And in near future, while writing a thesis of your PhD work or writing a research paper, you will not plagiarize. So I will request all my audience to actually believe in yourself and stop plagiarism. I have prepared this slide taking into account the various lectures of NPTEL course, their course materials, right? And that is why it's a part of my reference. Moreover, I have taken informations from Turnitin.com, Ithenticate.com. Turnitin and Ithenticate are basically the tool for checking plagiarism. So I will request the researcher, the one who is writing papers, one who is writing books, they should submit their particular article in Ithenticate or Turnitin to find out that whether the contents have any plagiarism or not. If there is plagiarism, what percentage of plagiarism is there and how to reduce it? That should be done. So I want my audience to do it. I want to give a short feedback of the NPTEL course of academic writing. The lecture videos are short, communicative, informative, and engaging. Webinars are very, very interactive, and the course materials are very easy, very simple, and reader-friendly and interesting as well. Last but not the least, as assistant professor from Guru Nanak, I want to acknowledge academic writing course of SWAM NPTEL academic writing team for their work, the mentors who are so cooperative, and also the team members who are so cooperative, and they are always keeping us up to date with the new information, and the mentors are guiding absolutely perfect. So I will acknowledge that, and I will thank to academic writing team of SWAM NPTEL. Thank you.